make your block for your table runner, follow the instructions starting on page 19. You'll start with the diamond shape, diamond C, and the small triangle of your star fabric. You'll stitch to one side, press your seams open towards your star fabric, and then stitch the second side on. Using units that have engineered corners, it's very easy to place that second block directly on that side and see how those engineered corners make it so our seam will be perfect every time. Once you have the unit pressed open, you will have a triangle that looks like this. You'll stitch to that one of your equilateral pieces by laying it flat and stitching along that straight edge. Once you've done that, press it towards your equilateral piece. Marty's pattern on page 19 says you'll need three of those units. You'll need three to make one block, but to make the table runner, you'll need six of these units. Now you're ready to put your Seven Sisters block together. You should have, in order to make two blocks for the table runner, you should have six units that include the star fabric in your background, two each of the units that include the contrast fabric and the star fabric, two units that include the contrast fabric that are at the bottom, and six units that are the longer strip. Go ahead and follow the instructions beginning on page 19 to put your rows together and assemble your blocks. To piece your block together, please turn to page 19 of Marty's pattern. You'll note in step 3, she shows you how to put the block together. You'll start by putting one of your diamond tip strips along the bottom of the block. Then you'll need to sew the two top strips together before you can add the diamond strips to the sides. Once you've done that, you can put your complete block together. And you'll need one diamond, the diamond number 52 from Marty's template set, from your star fabric. I'm going to use a scrap from my fabric. That way I don't have to cut into my remaining fabric because I can still make another block and another table topper out of that. Align one side of that parallelogram with that scrap of fabric and go ahead and engineer those corners. Follow the instructions on page 20 to make that center diamond. Using one of the strips of the contrasting fabric of the 2.5-inch strips, use your number 52 parallelogram. Use your number 52 diamond to cut two parallelograms. They will be skinnier than your diamond shape, but that's okay, that's what we need to complete that center unit. Lay the two on top of each other and use your diamond to notch off those engineered corners. Once you've stitched your side pieces onto that center block unit, you'll use your rotary cutter and your ruler to cut that unit into a diamond shape. Use your equilateral ruler to engineer those corners. Now the unit is ready.
add the triangle pieces that are necessary in order to complete your table runner.
Once I finished Marty's full table runner, I used my leftover pieces to make this small table topper, making just 3 Seven Sisters blocks.